break statement. It allows programmers to terminate the loop. Like when you want to suddenly jump out of a set of statements, you can use this. It skips from the loop or block in which it is defined. The control automatically goes to the first statement after the loop or block. It can be associated with all the conditional statements. So the break, it's not necessary, it has to be used only with switch. It can be used with any conditional construct. And its advantage is that when you just want to jump out of a set of statements, you simply give break, the compiler will automatically skip the block. So this is an example program using switch. You have the header files, you have the main function, you have the declaration of variables and the library function for clearing the screen, and you're printing a set of statements. That is, here you are trying to do some calculator functions like addition and subtraction. So I've included just three functions, addition, subtraction, and larger of 2. And based on my choice, I can do whichever function I want. So here printf, enter the choice and scanf. Now I am entering the choice 2. And then here you have an if construct which checks whether this ch has been entered between 0 and 3. This is because I have only 3 options. So if I'm going to enter some value like 4 or 5, the compiler will not know what to execute. So here itself I'm checking that whatever option I enter should be between 0 and 3. So if it is so, then accept the numbers from the keyboard. Printf enter 2 numbers, I'm entering 2 numbers 7 and 3 using the scanf statement, and that is assigned to A and B. Then I'm closing the if construct. So the if statement ends here. Next I move on to the switch block, switch ch. So ch is nothing but the variable or expression which contains either 0 or 1 or 2 or 3. So switch ch is nothing equivalent to switch 2, because I have entered the option 2, it is switch 2. So I'm opening the braces, I've given 2, so the compiler will check the case 1. 1 is not equal to 2, it will skip that block. It will automatically come to case 2, it will perform the subtraction, c is equal to a minus b. I've entered 7 and 4, so that will be, the difference will be determined and I will print the difference. So this is how a switch case is executed. I have case 1, 2 and 3, and if case 0 is there, which is terminated by choice, I don't have an option for 0. And if none of these cases, if I don't enter 0 or 1 or 2 or 3, automatically the default case of invalid choice will be printed. So this is how a switch case construct can be used. Next we move to the continue statement, which is just used in any case construct. It is to continue the set of iteration statements. And when it occurs in a loop, it does not terminate but skips the statements after the current statement. That is a somewhat opposite of break. Break is to suddenly terminate. The continue will just leave the current statement and start executing after that. It's useful when we want to continue the program without executing just some part of the program.